Oh, hey, G, you gotta wake up, my friend. Wake up, buddy.
Pastor Carl?
You gotta get up, yeah.
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here? What are you doing here? This is the set of Kids Church TV.
Oh, no. I must have fallen asleep.
It's Pastor okay.
Carl, I'll go grab my stuff. I'll be right back.
All right, sounds good. Hey, kids, I'm Pastor Carl, and that's G. We're glad you're here with us on Kids Church TV. Wow, G, we're back here again at Kids Church TV. How are you feeling today?
Oh, I'm feeling great, Pastor Carl. I'm so excited for what we're going to do today. I had breakfast this morning, so
excellent.
I'm good to go. I'm excited for our Bible story, and I'm so excited to worship. I even practiced singing this morning. You want to hear?
Sure. We want to hear it, right?
Okay, listen. Do, re, mi.
Oh, okay.
How's that?
Oh, well, that was something. Noise. It was music, I guess.
Thank you, Pastor Carl. I've really been practicing.
Cool.
But hey, I also looked ahead and saw that our Bible story today is about the fall. So I thought it was brilliant. I went and I got myself some leaves.
Oh, well, it is about the fall, but not the season, the fall. It's about the fall of mankind, which isn't about a season, but about sin. It's another S word, but not the same one. Sin, not the season.
Oh,
wrong
okay.
fall. Yeah.
Okay, well,
sorry, man.
I guess I'll just leave these over here because, you know, they're leaves and we'll keep going. Huh?
Yeah, let's do that. Let's leave that alone. Kids, here we go. Our big idea for Kids Church TV today. Drum roll, please. God is our Savior. Whew. This is our big idea for today.
No kidding, Pastor Carl. God is our Savior. That sounds like something that is super important for us to know.
Absolutely. And we're going to learn all about what that means in our episode today. But before we move on, G, let's review our memory verse with the kids.
Great idea. Okay, kids, I wonder if any of you have memorized our verse yet. We've already talked about God being everlasting, so let's find out if you remember it. Our memory verse is from Psalms 90, verse 2. And it says, "From everlasting to everlasting, you are God."
That was great, everyone. Nice job. What a great time now to stand up and worship God. G, are you ready to worship? Perfect.
All right. Pastor Carl.
Let's all stand up wherever you are right now, boys and girls, and let's worship God together.
You made my ears.
One, two.
So I can listen. You made my eyes,
one, two.
So I can see. You made my arms,
one, two.
So I can praise you. You made my heart, so I can love. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you.
gotta say, you have a great singing voice. I have a question for you. How often do you massage your throat before singing?
I don't ever massage my throat before singing.
What?
Yeah.
Seriously, you don't?
No.
Wow, you gotta give me some lessons sometime then.
Maybe, but right now we have some big news to go to.
Oh, is it time for Reporter Rick?
You got it, G. For some of the biggest news happening right now, let's go to the Good News News Desk with Reporter Rick.
Is my makeup okay? Great, we're live. Yes, hello boys and girls, and welcome to the Good News Desk of Reporter Rick. I am indeed Reporter Rick. I realize I said that twice. It was for dramatic effect. Anywho, moving on. Welcome to the Good News News Channel, where we love hearing all about the good news from around the world. So now, let's get down to some of those amazing news stories. First, there was a little boy from Buffalo who accidentally dropped his jumbo hot dog. Wow. But thankfully, his dad was there to save it before it hit the ground. What a close one. How awful it would have been to see that delicious, jumbo, juicy hot dog hit the ground. But you know, kids, while our dads are great, only God is our savior who can save us from our sins. Next up, there was a little girl who saved her grandpa's pet cat who was stuck in a tree. The cat's name was Whiskers. What a wonderful name for a precious little kitten. This grandfather, I'm sure, was so thankful that his granddaughter saved his cat. But do you think that she could save her grandfather from his sin? I don't think so, boys and girls. Only God is our savior who can do that. Our final story today comes from a tiny house in a big forest where the name is so long that I can't even pronounce it. A brother and sister saved their mom from a bad hair day when they noticed their mom had a giant ball of gum in their hair. Thankfully, they were able to get it out. Hopefully, they didn't eat it. Boys and girls, never eat gum from someone's hair. Now, while they could do that, they are not their mom's savior. Only God is our savior, boys and girls. Remember that. Well, that's all we have time for today, little ones. From the Good News News Channel, I'm Reporter Rick. Back to you guys in the studio.
Wow, that Reporter Rick sure knows his stuff. And how great is it that we get to hear some good news from the Good News News Station, right, G?
Oh, that is so right, Pastor Carl. Well, kids, let's get to our Bible teaching for today. I am so excited for the next part of our story. So let's hear what happens today in God's big story.
Hey, boys and girls. Last week, we learned that God is everlasting. That means he has always been here. Nobody made God, and God will never stop being God. He will always be there. He made this world and everyone and everything in it. He made me, and he made you. We also learned that Adam and Eve had a perfect relationship with God while they lived in the garden. The Garden of Eden was a wonderful place with everything they would need to live forever and ever. God told Adam and Eve they could eat of every kind of fruit in the garden except for the fruit of one tree in the center of the garden. At first, Adam and Eve obeyed, but one day, a very clever snake lied to Eve. Can you imagine a talking snake? That's so crazy. The snake told Eve what God said about the tree was not true. Boys and girls, does God ever tell us things that aren't true? No, God is perfect, and he always tells the truth. Eve decided to believe the snake and disobey God. Sin is anything that goes against what God says. Eve took a bite of the fruit and then gave it to Adam, and he took a bite too. Right away, they knew that they had made a very big mistake. While God was on a walk in the garden, Adam and Eve heard him coming, so they hid behind some trees. Do you ever hide? Maybe you hide when you know you've done something wrong, because sometimes when you disobey, you're given consequences. What does that mean, a consequence? A consequence is something that needs to happen when we make a mistake or we disobey to help us learn. There was going to be a big consequence because of what Adam and Eve had done. God already had a plan to help them, to save them and us from the consequence of what they did. Now, Adam and Eve are our ancestors, which means they're basically like our great-great-great-great-great-grandparents. We also need a savior because all of us have sinned against God, and Adam and Eve passed their sin on to everyone who's in their family, which is all of us. God knew that Adam and Eve were hiding from him. Where are you? God God asked, Adam answered and told him they were hiding because of what they had done, even though God already knew, because God knows everything. He asked them what happened. When they told God they disobeyed him and ate the fruit from the tree, God told them that they would have to leave the garden. God's love for Adam and Eve never changed though, even though they had disobeyed him and had to have a big consequence. No longer would they get to live with God in the garden or eat from all of the other beautiful trees there. No longer would they get to live forever. Now they would have to find a new home and work very hard for the things that they would need. They would experience pain, and someday they would even die. Because of what Adam and Eve did, no one would be able to have a perfect relationship with God. But God already had a plan to change that. This can all sound really sad and scary, but remember, our big idea today is that God is our Savior. That means He never leaves us alone. God saw and heard what happened in the garden, and He had a plan to fix it all. God made a promise to send a Savior, someone to take away all of our sins so we can be in a perfect relationship with Him again. The promised Savior would wipe away all the sin of Adam and Eve, my sin and your sin, if we believe in Him. He would save us. Who is this promised Savior? Jesus. Jesus is the promised Savior who saves us from our sin. But Jesus hadn't come yet, and there was going to be a lot of time until He did. But until He came, God was going to remind us over and over that He had a plan and that He was going to keep His promise because He knew we needed a Savior. You and I are part of God's big story. That means that we all have sinned and disobeyed God. But that also means that God's promise to send a Savior was a promise for you and a promise for me as well.
Wow! God is my Savior. Pastor Carl, do you know what that means?
Yeah, I think I have a pretty good idea that I know what that means.
Well, kids, I hope that you know what this means. It means that God loves you so much that He wants to be your Savior. It means He loves you so much that He wants you to spend forever with Him in heaven.
Hey, G, I have an idea, a little activity we can do,
okay,
and that the kids can do as well.
Okay, so that's great. What is it?
So let's give the boys and girls 10 seconds to come up with as many ideas of things that absolutely, definitely cannot, they won't save them. What do you think about that? Do you think they can do that?
Oh, wow, that is a very interesting idea. Oh, and do we have like a countdown? A countdown that we could put up for the kids while they do it. I love a good countdown. You know why? It's kind of like the countdown to New Year's when everyone goes 3, 2, 1, Happy New Year.
Okay, yeah, all right, yeah.
Okay, you know what? I was just checking.
We can do that. Okay, kids, wherever you are, all right, what we want you to do is stand up with your teacher in your classroom or at home with your parents and say as many things as you can think of that are not your Savior, things that cannot save you from your sin, all right? Here we go.
Okay.
Let's get the timer ready.
Yeah, let's go.
All right.
Put up our 10-second timer.
And go. Wow, 10 seconds goes fast. I wonder how many examples you got. Maybe 5, maybe 10, maybe like 100 or 1,000 or 1,000,000 or a whole lot. Hey, G, let's see how you can do.
Me?
Yeah, what we'll do is we'll have 60 seconds and I'll give you different options and you let me know if those things can save you from your sin. Are you ready?
Okay, I think I'm ready. I'm ready.
And go. Here's the first one. Getting good grades in school.
No.
Having a lot of friends who like you a lot.
Nope.
Doing all of your chores and always going to bed on time.
No.
What if your parents love God?
Ooh, that's an amazing thing to have, Pastor Carl, but parents who love God don't save you.
What about reading your Bible every day?
That's another great one, but that doesn't save you, Pastor Carl.
What about praying every time before you eat?
Oh, praying is so good every day, to do it every day, Pastor Carl, but that's not gonna save you.
What about a giant purple hippopotamus?
What? No.
What about a flying squirrel that has glasses?
Okay, now you're just being silly. Of course it's not gonna save you.
Okay, what about the biggest ball of yarn in the whole world?
Pastor Carl? You are just trying to trick me right now, aren't you?
You got it there, G. Yes, those were some silly things, but boys and girls, only God can save you. He is your Savior and mine.
Oh, that is so true. Now, let's sing one more song, boys and girls, to our awesome Savior God. Let's stand up and sing again. Let's go.
For you, I clap and lift my hands. Oh God, for you, I sing and dance.
Careful there, man. You don't want to hurt yourself.
Oh, what?
Playing
the
imaginary guitar there.
Pastor Carl, why didn't you tell me we're back on?
Yeah, it's okay. Don't worry. I'm sure the kids think that you're excellent at playing imaginary guitar.
Thank you. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, you are. You're good at it. Okay, you didn't miss any notes or anything like that.
Thank you, Pastor Carl. Yeah. Okay, nice. Well, now, wait, we want to get to some questions for today, don't we?
Yeah, let's do it. All right, kids. Here are some questions you're going to get to and talk about with someone in your classroom or in your house. So, here's what we're going to look at today. Question one, why did Adam and Eve disobey God? Think about the story today. Why did Adam and Eve disobey God? What happened after Adam and Eve sinned? What did God do? Do you remember what we learned today? Question three, how would you have felt if you were in the garden and God said that you had to leave because you broke your relationship with Him by being disobedient? How would you feel? And question four, now that you know that God is our Savior, what is something that you want to say to God?
Those are some great questions, Pastor Carl. I know they've got me thinking. Remember, boys and girls, you will go and talk with someone about these questions as soon as we're done here today.
That's right. Well, that's it for today.
Pastor Carl, is it really? Or do we have one more thing left to do today?
Hey, nice job, G. You remembered and you passed my memory test. We aren't quite done. Just what time is it, G? Do you remember?
It's time for our rewind.
This is where we rewind the episode today and look at some of the highlights and important things that we've learned. Are you ready? G, are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
All right, let's rewind now. God made a promise to send a Savior so we can be in a perfect relationship with Him again.
From everlasting to everlasting, you are God.
God is our Savior. Gee, you move real fast in rewind.
Ha, you were right, Pastor Carl. I do move fast when I'm being rewound.
I told you. All right, kids. That's all we have for you today. We are so happy that you were able to join us here on Kids Church TV.
And remember, boys and girls, God is our Savior. That means He loves us so much. He loves me, He loves you, He loves Pastor Carl so much that He made a plan to save us from sin and bring us back into a relationship with Him. Pastor Carl, could you pray for us?
Yeah, let's pray, boys and girls. God and Heavenly Father, we thank you that you love us so much that even though we have sinned, you love us enough to make a way for our sin to be forgiven and to know you, that you sent your Son Jesus to be our Savior. God, thank you that we're not stuck with our sin, but we have a way to be saved through you. We love you and pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, we will see you next time right here on Kids Church TV.
See ya.
Bye for now. Hey, way to go, man.
Nice.